In this video, I'll be explaining basic anatomy of trapezius muscle. Trapezius is very big muscle of shoulder girdle. Let's look at origin and insertion first. Actually, trapezius can be divided three parts. You see this beige tape? This represents superior part or superior fiber. This red tape is middle part or middle fiber. The blue one is lower part or lower fiber, however you want to call it. So, upper part, middle part, and lower part. Let's look at superior part first. The origin of superior part is on occiput. And some fibers attaches on nuchal ligament of cervical spine. Nuchal ligament is kind of connective tissue on cervical spines. So basically, you can remember upper part originates from occiput and cervical spine. And the middle fibers attaches on thoracic spine. You know, there's a gap in between these parts, but of course, there's fibers here as well. The origin for whole part is from occiput through T12. So it's very wide muscle. The origin is very wide. Occiput through T12. This is very big muscle. So I checked origin of trapezius. So let's look at insertion. This is interesting. So upper fiber is, you want to see from anterior part, attaches on lateral part of clavicle. It attaches on clavicle actually. Then it attaches on this part. This part is part of scapula. And this is acromion. The superior part attaches on clavicle and acromion. Then the middle part also attaches on the acromion, but more medial side, and the spine of scapula. The lower part attaches on spine of scapula as well. Basically, so trapezius attaches on clavicle and scapula. So this is basic attachment. Occiput, cervical spine, thoracic spine, then all the way down to T12, okay? So let's look at function of trapezius. The all three fibers do adduction. What is adduction? Adduction is like you pull scapula this way. So it is like this movement. You kind of close shoulder blade together. So this is adduction. All the three parts do adduction. But if you want to be very specific, each fiber does different movement. Let's look at it. So when superior fiber contract, it can bring scapula up, right? Because the direction of the fiber is this way, right? So if muscle pulls bone this way, it can do elevation, kind of shrugging the shoulder. This is elevation. And the direction is not completely vertical, right? It's pulling bone this way, so it can do upward rotation of scapula. Upward rotation is like this way, rotational movement for this way. Why? Because muscle is pulling bone this way, then rotational movement happens. This is very interesting. So far, I said superior part does elevation and upward rotation. However, since trapezius attaches on occiput and cervical spine, if scapula is fixed, this doesn't move. Upper part also does movement of cervical spine, which is like extension. You look up. Or if one side contracts, it can do side bend. You know, bend the neck this way. Or if you want to be very, very specific, this can also do rotation. So it can do extension, side bend, or rotation. Okay? The upper part does so many things. I will repeat again. Upper part, elevation, upward rotation, neck extension, side bend, and rotation. So let's go to the medial part. By the way, actually, medial part only does adduction, because you know direction of medial part is kind of horizon, right? It runs like horizontally, so it pulls scapula this way, which is adduction, right? So it doesn't do any kind of vertical movement or rotational movement. This is pure adductor. Let's go to inferior part. So if muscle pulls the scapula this way, what's gonna happen? It does depression. This is depression. It was elevation, and this is depression. So lower part does depression of scapula. By the way, lower part also does rotational movement. Which one is that? Upward rotation or downward rotation? Which one does inferior part? Actually, upward rotation. This is very confusing part, because if muscle pulls this way, it looks like it does downward rotation, right? Pulls scapula this way. Actually, it does upward rotation. Imagine, if I grab scapula here, the medial part, and pull this way, what's gonna happen? Scapula will rotate this way, right? Because direction of force is going this way, and it pulls scapula this way. This is upward rotation. So lower part, depression, and upward rotation. So the superior fiber and inferior fiber do upward rotation. This is very interesting thing. Then one more thing about superior part. It attaches on occiput, as I said, and there's very important nerve and blood vessel passing here. What are they? They are greater occipital nerve and occipital artery. These two tissues, greater occipital nerve and occipital artery, are so important for headache. These are very important for headache. Also, if superior part gets tight, what's gonna happen? It kind of compress the cervical spine and neck, then it can create neck pain or headache. Tightness of this part is very common. Why? Because we use smartphone, computer, tablet, we go this way, right? Kind of hunching this way. So the upper part contracts, keep contracting, and this part gets tight. It will pinch nerve or artery or other muscles, then you get tightness here. Very common. And one more part that we can easily get tightness is around here. Also the superior part. And you know, you have ever had the tightness around here. Oh my gosh, my shoulder is very tight. That can be your trapezius. So upper part is very important for tight shoulder and tight neck. Freaking important. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy of trapezius. Its origin, insertion, the function, and important thing about superior part. So this is today's video. If you liked it, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you in next video.